Hi loves and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. My name is Morgan. I make videos about luxury handbags, fashion, and lifestyle, so if that's your thing, please subscribe and turn on notifications. I upload twice a week and I would love to have you here. Today I'm getting into a much requested guide to buying pre-loved designer handbags. I have been shopping pre-loved for years. Like, I really compare new versus pre-loved, what's the best price, where I can get the style that I want. So that if you're not used to buying pre-loved, it can be a bit intimidating. You don't know where to start. You don't know what's trustworthy or reliable. This is a video more for tips and tricks of shopping pre-loved, things you should look for, the websites that I use, things to avoid as well. I'm gonna share also mistakes I've personally made so you can maybe avoid those things as well, because you know, when you're not buying something directly from the store, there is just, you know, no guarantees. So you are taking a bit of a chance. There are things you can do to mitigate the risks of shopping pre-loved. I'm gonna share with you tips that I've learned over the 10 plus years I've been shopping from pre-loved. I hope you find some helpful tips. I have a video if you're looking for specific styles I recommend buying pre-loved. I'll pop that up here. But this is more for the tips and a guide of really how to get the best deal and where you can go to get pre-loved designer bags. So first I wanna just generally go over how I find the best deal, and that's by comparing different websites. I'm gonna list my favorite websites in the next section, but the idea is that you don't wanna look at just one site. There are certain sites that are better for certain bags than others, so just taking some time to compare different sites and being patient is really gonna help you find the best deal. There's a few things I need to point out here, and that's the size of the bag, the color of the bag, the condition of the bag can affect the price greatly. What I do to start is I compare from at minimum 3 to 4 different websites, same exact bag in the same size, same color hardware, and as similar of color as I can find to get an average pre-loved price. Then once I'm seeing, okay, this deal looks too good to be true, that's when you need to go in, look at the condition really carefully and see, is there something there that's, you know, not so great about the condition that's causing this price to be extra low? Or if you see one that's just way above the average price, then you know, like, okay, that's not a good deal, I'm not gonna go for that. So really doing your research between at least 3 to 4 sites is gonna help you make a better buying decision when you're buying pre-loved. Also wanna take a look at the brand's own website, because there are some bags that are a better deal new than pre-loved. There's certain limited editions or desirable colors or, you know, certain shapes that are just so hard to get your hands on. I mean, think about the Birkin. That goes for 1.5 to 2 times over retail typically, depending on how desirable the color is. So looking at the brand's own website to know the price. Also websites like Purse Forum and Purse Bop that list the current prices for popular designer bags. So you want to have an idea of what the price is new so you can start comparing the pre-loved prices. I have a couple of videos on bags that you should buy new as well on my channel. I'll pop one up here in case you're interested, because I do a lot of research before I buy any bag, be it in the store or pre-loved. I compare prices new versus pre-loved and amongst different websites. In those videos, you'll also find some good advice to score some of the more difficult bags to find. Now let's talk where I shop pre-loved. So I'm gonna show you also some of the bags that I have found pre-loved over the years. I just love the hunt for a bag. Like, sometimes there are styles that, you know, came out when I was like too young to really be carrying designer bags, or I missed out on the style because it was such a popular style and I couldn't get my hands on it. Or the bag just doesn't retain its value pre-loved, so then it's a really good idea to get a discount versus buying new. The number one website I go to over and over again, kind of as a benchmark of the industry standard of pre-loved, is Fashionphile, and that is where I found this gorgeous pink Chanel. This bag was under $1,000. I have a video unboxing this. I'll pop it up here. In excellent condition. What I love about Fashionphile is they give you multiple detailed photos that you can zoom in on and really check the condition. They also list the condition not just as like good, fair, excellent. They go into detail, like if the interior has something wrong with it, they list it. So reading that description is really, really helpful. I will say for newer bags, they can be quite pricey. Like whatever the it bag is right now, their price is usually the highest. So for brand new bags, it's not always the best place to go. If you're looking for an older or a vintage style like this, they're typically one of the better places to go, especially for Chanel. Also picked up my Chanel nylon bag, which so many of you guys love. You're always asking me if I'm gonna sell this or if I have links to it. I'm never gonna sell it, but whenever I do see one pop up, I add them on my Instagram story, so make sure you're following me there if you're looking for a nylon Chanel. But this bag was around like $600. Actually like a lower price than the new Prada nylon, so Chanel being my favorite brand, this was like a no-brainer. So you can find some really unique and special pieces on Fashion File. The thing about them that I will say though is that pieces go fast. When they are priced well on Fashion File, when you find that unicorn, it goes very quickly. So I really suggest if you're hunting for something or you're just looking for the best deal possible, you need to be checking the new in page every single day. And that will help you find the best deal. But Fashion File is definitely my number one. They have an authenticity guarantee. I think larger websites get a bad rap because occasionally, maybe a bag can slip through the cracks, it's not real. But if you find that your bag is not real, you can get your money back. So I feel safer buying that way because in the pre-loved market, that's kind of like just a hazard of shopping pre-loved. Every shop that I'm recommending does the best that they can to filter out and authenticate every bag. But when you're doing high volumes of pre-loved, one can slip through the cracks. So I try to look for sites that have authenticity guarantees, and I'll speak more about that later on how you can double check your bag. Very safe buying from Fashion File. I've personally never had a problem buying Fashion File. All of my bags have been real. All of them have been as described, so they still are my number one choice. Next is Yuji's Closet, and I got this giant Chanel there. I've had this for many years. It's just a big hobo bag, and I'm so glad that big bags are back again because I want to start wearing this more. It's such a fun bag. I love Yuji's Closet because they're smaller compared to Fashion File and The RealReal. They get a really unique selection. Sometimes you see bags there that you don't see at the other websites. So they are typically one of my websites that I compare for prices. But occasionally you can find a bag at Yuji's Closet that's priced much better than Fashion File or The RealReal in a really good condition. Also really good about giving a lot of pictures and describing the condition well so you know exactly what you're getting into. And I really also like that they tell you what the retail price was and what their price is. Even if the bag is more expensive than the retail price, they let you know that you're kind of paying that markup and they tell you the percentage that you're saving. I really appreciate that because we all know there are some styles that you just can't get your hands on in store, and people are gonna be willing to pay above retail. I wouldn't pay above retail for just any bag, but for a specific unicorn bag that I just couldn't get my hands on, there are a couple of bags I can think of I would be willing to do that for. So if there is that type of bag for you that you're looking for, at least they're honest about it and you really know that you're paying above. The one thing I wish more websites would do, because a lot of people, especially with Chanel and Hermes pricing, it's hard to find those prices online. Chanel does not list every single style that they sell on their website. So if you're looking for a very particular piece, you might not even know the retail price of it. So I really, really appreciate that about Yuji's Closet. They also have an authenticity guarantee. So it's another one you can shop safely from. Number three is The RealReal, and that's where I found my saddle bag. Now I did get my saddle bag before, like right at the beginning when it started getting popular again. Got mine at a better price than what they're listed for now. So I find The RealReal is actually a little pricey for saddle bags compared to some of the other websites. RealReal is a funny one where it really depends on what you're looking for, if the RealReal is gonna be a good deal or not. One of the biggest pre-loved sites, and they get so many items in, it can be easy to get sucked into, oh, they have it, I'm gonna buy it. But I really encourage you, if you are shopping on the RealReal, make sure you compare to other websites. Or a site that has come in the news about, you know, finding some fake pieces from there, but again, they have an authenticity guarantee, so if one slips through the cracks, they are probably the biggest pre-loved site that I know of with the most amount of stuff coming through their site. So I think at the volumes that they do, if one or two pieces slips through the cracks, I think that's kind of just a hazard of the industry. Kind of don't buy into this cancel culture just because there's been a few incidences that, you know, everything there is like fake. That's not true. And I really do find them to be quite a reliable source to buy from, and I have never had any of my items turn up fakes. Kind of weary of using them. There are external authentication sites that you can use to authenticate your handbag. I encourage you to do that if you're really feeling like, oh, I'm not so sure, but personally, I've never had any problems and I continue to buy from them. Number four is a site that I personally have not bought from before, but I'm always scrolling. That is Vestiaire Collective, and this is one of those sites that like you can get something from all over the world, kind of like an eBay but for designer stuff. If someone has a small pre-loved like store and they want to take it online, Vestiaire is a really good website for them to do that. They do rate their sellers and they say like trusted seller or top seller and kind of give you a degree of confidence, because you can also just personally list an item there. It really is like with eBay, it's one of those things where you want to kind of look into the bag, you want to look into the seller. It does have an authentication process, so you can buy with confidence there. But if you, again, it's one of those that like, if you're feeling any doubt, use an external authentication site. And if you find out that that report says that your bag is fake, then you can take that to them and make a case against it. I've seen a lot of other people in the luxury YouTube space buy from them and have zero problems. And I really haven't heard of a whole lot of bad reports from the website. So I do think that it is one that I can recommend with pretty good confidence, even though I haven't bought from them personally. I do know a lot of people who have bought from them with much success. Five is a UK-based reseller that I haven't bought from yet, but so many UK YouTubers buy from the site, and it's Luxury Promise. Find some of the most unique vintage Chanel pieces, and their prices are quite good as well. It's one of those you want to be following on Instagram. It's also one of those where when they get the item and it's a really good item at a good price, it sells very fast. Literally to my number six, which is Cellier Knightbridge. I watch their stories literally every single day because they get some of the coolest items. They're really well priced. I don't believe in the exorbitant, extortionate prices that you see like with Hermes. They do have, they are a little bit above retail, but they're not going to be like double the price of the bag. Like, they don't want to be a part of that problem in the pre-loved market, and I really appreciate that. And they're one that I'm really watching to find my perfect Kelly as well. I'm hoping just one day it will pop up on their site. No, at their markup, I would be willing to pay their markup for the Kelly, but I wouldn't be willing to pay, you know, double the bag that you see it on other pre-loved sites for. Those are two that I really recommend following them on Instagram, checking their stories every day, and you can really see the pieces that they have. And what I really like is, especially on Cellier Knightbridge, they're always exposing people who bring them fake bags, and they show like, this is fake, this is what you need to look out for. They really take pride in making sure that their items are authentic, and they take that process very seriously. A lot of top luxury YouTubers, even Lydia Millen, has bought from them. So I can recommend them with confidence because it's one that's on my radar. It's just the right piece hasn't come up yet. I had to mention one for my UAE-based followers. Now, the pre-loved market over here is really hard for me to recommend. I literally block replica accounts based in the UAE that sell fake bags almost daily. Issue is with recommending a lot of pre-loved sites here is I don't know that I fully trust the authentication. Only one I have shopped from that is based here so far is the Luxury Closet. Bought my Fendi bag out there. Here's the thing, I've also sold with them. The thing is I don't know how much I trust their authentication, and I only say this because I've sold with them and they sent back an item saying it was not authentic when I bought it directly from Nordstrom in the US. It's a limited item that was only for the US market, so maybe they just weren't aware of that style. It was a pair of Valentino shoes. I'm not 100% sure how good their authenticators are, but the reason I have bought with them is they do have an authenticity guarantee. So I would buy from them again, and I'm pretty good personally about knowing fakes from real bags and stuff like that. But if you are not, I highly recommend if you do buy from them, get your bag authenticated externally from one of these other websites. And if you find that it's fake, then you can go back to them with that report because they do have an authenticity guarantee. I do recommend them, but just with that warning. Number eight is, you know, one of the all-time classics, and that's What Goes Around Comes Around in New York. Here's the thing with them. They get some of the most rare Chanel pieces and some of the most beautiful condition items, but because they're super selective and premium with their products, they are 9 times out of 10 above the average pre-loved price for their items. So if you're looking for something super rare, you have the budget to spend, and you don't care what the price is, they're the store to go to. If you want that really unique vintage Chanel, they're the store to go to. But just be ready to pay the premium. Some of their vintage styles go for more than new style Chanels. Not one I'm recommending if you're trying to get a good deal pre-loved. It is a store with a good reputation that gets unique pieces that you can really buy from with confidence. So that's why I added it to this list. I check it every now and then. It's not one in my normal rotation. It's more of one to see like, oh, what super unique piece do they have today? And do I happen to need it? Which I haven't bought from them for many years. So that tells you how often like I really look to get their pieces. Have that base collection and you're looking for that super special piece, this is the site to go to. Number 9 is actually Poshmark, but with a disclaimer. I would only purchase an item that is above $500 because then Poshmark does authenticate the item. If you are new to buying designer and you're worried about it, I would also recommend doing your own authentication through one of the external sites I'm gonna mention later. This is the thing like with Poshmark, it's just like eBay, anyone can list something. So you really wanna pay attention to the description. If they're using kind of vague language, like they're not saying like, authentic, or you know, if they're not willing to tell you like where they bought it, like what store they bought it from, or you know, if there's something that seems off, or like if they say things like designer quality, designer inspired, those are things to stay away from on Poshmark. But if you see an item that's claiming to be authentic, you message the seller and you know, everything seems normal and you want to go through with it, and it'll be sent to Poshmark. If it's over $500, they'll authenticate it and then send it to you. So you can buy things on there. I bought my Chanel belt there. I was happy with my experience, but I have also bought from Poshmark. I bought an off-white belt thinking it was real. And it was not. Was able to return it after making a claim with Poshmark. It kind of taught me that lesson with Poshmark to really only buy designer items that are over that $500 price point where Poshmark authenticates the item. 10th and final like recommendation or like where I shop or look at is from other luxury lovers on Instagram. You have to be careful with this. You really have to follow someone and know how they are as a person, you know, watch their stories, see what they buy. If they're showing their unboxing and showing them shopping in the store. So I bought this bag from Stephanie. I will link her Instagram below. Every now and then she sells a few of her designer bags she's not using on her stories. I think my tips when buying from someone on Instagram, really know them and their content. If you see them shopping in these stores, you see them buying the bags, you see them unboxing them. If you've been following them for a while and you realize they don't promote fakes, they're very against it. Those are some of the YouTubers, content creators that you can potentially buy their pre-loved bags. And that's often the best way to get the best deal. So I also sell my bags. I tend to price mine below the average pre-loved price because when you sell through a pre-loved website, they take a cut of profit. So I eliminate some of that and I try to price well. That's what I find a lot of other content creators do as well because you know, if you have designer bags and you've tried to sell them before, when you go through all these platforms, even Poshmark, they take a cut of your profit. You want to make sure that you're not buying from someone who is okay with fake items. Only ask for pictures, ask them where they bought the bag or how they got the bag, because if they're willing to tell you this information and they're upfront and honest about the condition and the bag, 9 times out of 10, you're going to be fine. I wouldn't just buy from just anyone on Instagram. I don't recommend that. But from someone who creates content around luxury items and they sell their pre-loved items and you've seen them unbox it or buy it from the store, you can kind of have an idea, you know, this is a real item. And again, you can always externally authenticate the bag as well. Now let's talk about getting your bag authenticated. I've personally never had to do it because I'm pretty good. I have had a bag turn up fake before and I was like, listen, this is not what was pictured. And this was through an eBay seller and why I don't buy through eBay anymore. Really, I paid through PayPal and it was all handled and I got my money back. Honestly, it was when the deal was too good to be true. It was a Supreme Louis Vuitton collaboration piece and the price was less than the average pre-loved price and I should have known better, but I wanted the piece so bad that I took a chance and the chance didn't work out. So lesson learned, won't do that again. When it turned up, I could tell it was fake, but not everyone can do that. Not everyone is so studied in designer bags. It's, you know, not a skill set that you really require in life. If you need a little help with authenticating a bag, two websites I hear about the most are Real Authentication and Entropy. Can't really speak on how it works and the full process, but I'll link both of their websites below so you can find out more about it yourself. And I know many, many YouTubers who have used these services and highly recommend them. Personally reached out to a few to ask which ones they use, and these were the two that came up, and I've also heard them mentioned in videos. So if you are ever in doubt, or if you're buying from a website and you know you just want to be extra safe, it's worth the little bit of extra money, because if it did turn up fake and the website has an authenticity guarantee, you can get your money back. Now for my tips for buying pre-loved. These are just kind of rules I've put in place for myself that help protect me as a buyer, and things that I avoid and things that I also look for that can really help me buy smarter pre-loved. And they're things I've learned over 10 plus years. So I've made a lot of mistakes myself, and I want to help you avoid these mistakes. These are my top tips for buying pre-loved. My first tip is to look for an authenticity guarantee. I tend to avoid Instagram sellers or websites that don't have an authenticity guarantee. If they're not willing to stand behind their authentication process and what they're selling, it's not a place that I would really recommend buying from. So that is number one. The thing is, you know, like I've said in this video, when you're doing volumes of pre-loved items, there's bound to be a few slip through the cracks by accident. But when a company gives an authenticity guarantee, if you find out your bag has turned up fake, some of them even give lifetime authenticity guarantees. You can take that proof to them and the bag and show them, my bag is not real, and they will refund your money. For me, that is a business that's saying, you know, this is a hazard of being in this business, and this is how we are going to take care of the situation if it ever happens. Second tip is to do your price comparison research and avoid deals that are too good to be true. Yes, I have gotten some amazing deals in my life, but it's typically when I've been lucky about buying it at the time when it wasn't the most popular, like my Fendi baguette. I got that for $214 right before the baguettes got their resurgence. But now, if I was to find a Fendi baguette at that price, I would think, oh, that's probably fake, because the average pre-loved price for that is now between $800 to $1,000 for a vintage one. Doing that research and kind of knowing and avoiding those things too good to be true will help you buy more safely. Sometimes you will find someone who just wants to sell quickly, and maybe they'll price it slightly below the average pre-loved price. That's personally what I do with mine. I price them slightly below, but it's not going to be like $1,000 below, or you know, 50% below the average pre-loved price. Just not going to happen typically. And when you see a deal that seems too good to be true, really look into why. Maybe it could just be it's the condition. It could be the fact that, you know, the condition is just so horrible. It's the only price they can command for that bag. Number three is to avoid bags where the condition is listed as dyed, refurbished, painted, or restored. These are all different terms for they've used a coloring to restore the color of the bag. This tanks the resale value. I would never buy a bag like this. Maybe the condition was just so horrendous that by doing this, they can at least just get some money out of the bag. But if you're not gonna take care of your designer bag that you have to restore it or paint it to make it look new again, then that's not a condition or a bag that I would wanna have, because most likely it'll have some other issues, some wear on the hardware, something on the inside. These are bags that I always avoid, and I don't recommend you doing that to your handbags either, because if you ever go to resell your handbags, it tanks the value. The best thing to do is to take care of your bag. I have a video for tips on taking care of your designer bags, which I'll pop up here if you want to know more about that. Fourth tip is to check every single picture and zoom in. If it says in the description that it has a mark on the corner, find that corner and see that mark in the picture. If they're not giving you detailed enough pictures to see the flaws that they're describing in the bag, that's a bit of a red flag for me. Sometimes I'll check out the condition, it'll say that there's a little flaw or something, and I'll be like, you know, that's a flaw that's gonna come if I use it as well. And I'm okay with that flaw, but at least I'm aware of every single flaw that there is. And that's something that you wanna take the time, because sometimes you just see a bag and you're like, oh my gosh, I need this bag. I wanna buy it right now before anyone snaps it up. Pause, breathe, check all the pictures first. Trust me, it will save you from making an expensive mistake. And my number five tip also goes with my fourth tip, and that is read the description of the item. Don't just read, okay, excellent condition, fine. Most websites will list different things in very good detail of what is going on with the bag. If there's, you know, something on the interior or the exterior. They're going to list it separately. Kitchen File is amazing with this. One of the reasons why I buy from them so frequently is because I know exactly what bag I'm going to get by the description and the pictures. So make sure you're reading the full description. It'll tell you what comes with the bag too. If it's a dust bag, if it's a box, if it's nothing, if the authenticity card has been lost. All of these things are really important in calculating, is this bag worth the price that it's being listed for? Is the condition worth the price? And you wanna make that comparison, and that's only a judgment you can make for yourself. Some things to look out for that I wanna mention are musty odors. I pretty much always avoid bags that say they have a musty odor. Again, the painted, dyed, or restored. Also wanna look out for if the zipper or any hardware has been replaced and not by the brand Bag Spa. Sixth tip is to have some patience. Bags come and go on the pre-loved market, some faster than others, some stick around. I think once you've done your research and you've taken that time and you know the average price, only time to start seriously looking for the bag once you have the money to spend. If that bag pops up at the right price, you have to be ready to buy it immediately. I think once you've already made the decision in your head, you know what quality you want, you know what price you want to pay that's reasonable as per your research, that is the time to start checking every day, check multiple sites, and keep an eye out for the bag. Certain bags have taken me more than 2 years to find, and those are bags that are more of like my lifetime bags, my unicorn bags. Most other bags are a bit easier to find, and of course, if you want the bag quickly, you can expect to pay the premium if it's quite popular. Having patience can also save you from buying into a trend too fast as well. If you're not finding it at a good price, being willing to wait for it and wait, you know, even 2 months or 3 months to find the perfect one, if you still want it after that time, after all that time of looking, then you really know that's a good bag for your collection and you've gotten the best price possible. Number 7 is to pay attention to the condition. Condition affects the selling price probably more than anything else. Color can also affect the selling price of the bag, how desirable the color is, and the popularity of the bag itself can affect the pre-loved price of the bag. But condition is the number one thing that really affects the price of the bag. This is why I don't really consider handbags an investment in terms of making money, because unless you've kept it in perfect condition, you can't really call it an investment because there's no guarantee that you'll make your money out of the bag that you bought. Pay attention to the condition versus the price. When you're looking and trying to create that average pre-loved price across multiple sites, don't just pull up a page of that bag. Go into each one and look at their condition ratings and say, okay, for good condition, it's X amount. For excellent condition, it's X amount. And keep that in mind. And then when you see a deal that seems too good to be true, you can say, okay, the condition is probably not the best. Let me go in and really take a look at this and see why this bag is the price that it is. Number 8 is to be careful who you buy from on Instagram. There are Instagram sellers I have used. Really do your research. Really make sure they're real people first. Avoid any kind of these crazy Instagram handles that'll be like bags country 2020 or bags country 2019. These are the most common fake accounts I see selling super fake bags. Or if they have some weird Instagram handle that seems like that's really odd, probably avoid them. You know that they're a real person, like, you know, a luxury YouTuber or a luxury Instagrammer. Probably safe for people to buy from because you've seen them document their shopping and unboxing experiences. The way that I kind of vet the people that I'm willing to buy from as Instagram sellers is that I have to kind of know through someone who has bought from them. Kind of look at the page and tell if they're really descriptive with the item, if their prices are, you know, around that average. If it's your first time buying pre-loved, I do recommend going with like the bigger sites with authenticity guarantees, but if you are getting into buying more and more pre-loved, you can start looking on Instagram. You can always send me a page that you're concerned about and I can give you my honest thoughts on it. Now, I am not the authority on everything, but I can say, oh, this might be something you should be concerned about, or, you know, it seems legitimate. I would ask the seller more questions. But my advice is just that, it's advice. You do need to do your own research as well, and your purchase decision is yours alone. Some things to be like weary of also is like legitimate resellers are not gonna be buying followers. If you're seeing someone do like shady Instagram tactics, I would be concerned about their business tactics. I was approached by a brand to do a collaboration and promote to you guys some their reselling page. They had over 10,000 followers, but when I went into their individual pictures, one, they didn't list the description well, like most legitimate resellers, and two, they had 6 to 10 likes on a picture. An account with 10,000 followers is not going to have that few of likes, even with the Instagram algorithms everyone likes to complain about. It is a very clear sign about buying followers, and they just forgot to buy their likes. Another sign is that there were no comments under the photos. There was like maybe the one odd comment under a random photo. But typically, if it's a legitimate reseller, they will have a very dedicated and, you know, wanting to buy community who will be asking questions about the bag. Dig into the comments as well and see what people are saying. If you see a reseller that just posts a picture, doesn't list the description, has no comments under the post, I would say stay away from that reseller. Be very careful and, you know, use a little bit of detective skills and look into the profiles that you're seeing selling bags on Instagram. Another thing you should really avoid is any account that says master, designer, or factory quality. This does not mean authentic. If some of them will even go so far as to say authentic quality. No legitimate store says authentic quality. That's not a term people use. A legitimate store will say these are authentic bags. Nitpicky with language, I know. These are subtle signs to look for. Find out if the seller is, you know, trying to play games or not. A legitimate business is going to use clear and concise language and descriptions. Definitely avoid anything that's using this like ambiguous language or confusing language. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a like. It really helps out with my channel. If you have any questions about buying bags pre-loved or you're confused about anything I said, leave those questions in the comments below. We'll be answering as many as I can through my knowledge. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram where you see how I style my bags. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.